and you can very consistently parry the third Q that for that massive damage on the sweet spot. You can always get that parry off, which is actually going to turn that around on the
Raven to chase down his enemy. Great play there by Optic. They're going to go ahead and be able to pick up the dragon. Now we see a little bit of rotation from Big. He doesn't go right back to the bottom. We'll see if they can activate anything.
Of, you know, Cleaver and this sort of thing.
Pushing in, final chapter's just gonna miss. Arrow's out of range, but he's walking into it, but he dodges the Glacial Prison as well. So much left and right, the Comet, he doesn't die! And the fight back onto GGS is going well in the way of Optic. That's gonna be all of GGS falling to the bot lane.
Counter is in order.
I mean, if they go for this, if Golden Guardian's engaged,
package is there.
Eos is waiting, and he's gonna be countering again.
They gotta go pretty deep for this one if they use the package. Good damage going down on Optic. Big's low, but he's gonna use the stopwatch. Dokla's into the fight. His crown is now coming down to throw out the soldiers, but is it gonna be in time? Oh, GGS is already getting torn apart and put on the ground. Monster's into the fight, but he wants out right away. And it looks like he will finally make it. Froggen was already flying out of that one. As soon as he soared in, the flight path changed immediately. And it looks like this turret will fall as much as GGS wanted to stop it.
Yeah. You see Meteos, right place, right time. Two counter ganks really have decided this game. Meteos has known exactly what Golden Guardians was waiting for. And both times he's in the brush, he's already waiting, and he does take it away.
They did get that.
Still waiting. They're all stacked up. Then he gets the knockup, goes straight in. Big, using that stopwatch to buy time. Arrow free fire.
That early mid game style of champion. So you are really in tough. And
wait, Optic will keep running right through. So see if Optic now can keep this pace rolling. And if Golden Guardians
can work down on turrets very quickly if you ever get access to them. As long as Dokla just plays it safe, like, you can just allow your team to carry you this game.
They want Meteos right here. Final chapter goes down. It looks like Optic's gonna have to leave him for dead, and they do so.
Coming
through. Hydra procced off for a bit of extra damage. Dokla's gonna be forced under his turret. Probably not ulting here, but he will not be able to participate with the team. His ult's up, but that teleport isn't. So they have to let this Drake go. GGS grabbing a bit of an advantage here. So who can get that Baron next?
Mid lane. This is happening, and Meteos and Crown are just gonna grab this.
Oh, amazing. 22 and a half minutes in.
River IE are really heavily kind of poke based scaling build here, and they're going in.
Onto Froggen, he's able to drag the depth charge quite a ways away to not affect the team. The turret's starting to take a bit of damage. That super cannon minion, or that Baron cannon minion is there. Nice Glacial Prison slows down the attack of Optic. And it looks like Sundisk will keep Optic safe, but you're right, they have to think of what's going on the other side of the map as they lose a second tier turret to Haunter.
Yeah, this is actually great from Golden Guardians. The fact that they were able to hold strong in that 4v5 despite the Baron buff and being so far behind in gold was really well done. They dropped pretty much all their ultimates there to try to do this, but that bought time for Haunter to take a turret, and it meant that Dokla now had to go back to base, which opens the potential for Haunter to come over here.
You gotta think, Azale, they used the Glacial Prison to deny the turret take last time. They don't, and they cannot afford that this time. And that goes down. The inhibitor is going to follow next. And 25 minutes in, Optic has broken the base of Golden Guardians.
They have, but Haunter
is
going for the inhibitor tower.
And Dokla can't fight him.
Yeah, Dokla can't fight him, but he could actually get collapsed on. The rest of Optic is running down here, so Dokla needs to play this safe, buy time for the rest of his team.
This is where you need to play the stop the backs game, but rightly so, Golden Guardians doesn't want to just come chasing out of their base. Looks like Haunter's going to go on Mission Impossible here to see if he can get himself out. A Q is used, denied under the turret as he takes a few charge shots. Big's going to throw out the anchor toss, and they lock him down. But what can GGS do amongst this time? They have to make some moves. They have to clear the map. Arrow's even taken Drake still. So Optic is picking more up as they're
able. Fiora doesn't do anything in that situation trying to wave clear, right? So you have the two items on your Fiora. Try to get it out.
Fall off the position of where they've been playing at such a high caliber. Crown's back, but I don't think he's going to give it up just yet.
They're
fighting each other. Dokla's in there. Baron's down to 600. Smite's going to be going over to Meteos. Optic feels good about this fight so far. Damage on the contracts is pretty good. Froggen's over the wall. There's a stopwatch to buy time, but that could be too much for the rest of the team. They need Froggen in the fight as well. And that's Arrow picking up two big kills. Shots over the wall from Froggen, but it's not going to be enough distance to get onto Crown. And man, Optic pick up Baron once again to do more damage to GGS.
And that could be the end of the game potentially here. They're actually looking to pick off Puhi, and they're just marching it down mid lane, keeping in.
Puhi on the ultimate roam there. He goes down as he is found out. And that's gonna be a kill for Dokla. They're going to be in front of the base with Arrow and Crown, moving in with that super minion and the Baron'd up wave. It's Haunter and Froggen on defense.
Yeah, they got to make something crazy happen here. Baron'd up minion waves. They're trying to buy time. FBI and Contracts will be up soon, but will it be quick enough?
Oh my word, the damage on the turrets. I don't think it's going to be enough, Azale. They can still keep it sub 30 if they keep this damage onto the structures. 29.50 on the clock. Here comes the defense. The cavalry has arrived from the fight, and Froggen's going to fire in the missiles. And on the exit, they take the inhibitor down, but it almost looks like they want to turn for the fight. Medios just gets himself alive with a flag and dragon. Oh. The stopwatch for Doka stays there.
Oh.
Last forward, and not even three want to take on Arrow inside the base. Just behind him is Crown, and they are ready to go to town on the Nexus. That's the hook coming in. They take down Contracts. They're signing off on this one, baby. Haunter's going to be next, and that's who he. Where's he going on this? He's looking to run out. The hills are that way, buddy. Who he goes down as a triple kill for Crown comes in, and he says, King me, as Optic are going to tie the top of the table with a win over Golden Guardians.
6-3 for Optic as Arrow has an absolute pop-off game.